Hello everyone, and welcome back to From Our Basement Gaming.
Hi everyone.
We are back with part 92 of our Ecco the Dolphin Defender of the Future.
Yeah, we are. Pretty much where we were last time. I'm at least happy that this level has some checkpoint system before. We got some generosity from the game as well.
Yeah. Which is good, I guess.
Anyway, jumping around
You've been chopping around for what?
Well, keeping tabs on the veterans.
Oh, you have?
Yeah. Yes. Because I was debating about doing the hotel thing for March or
whatever. Oh, yeah, I don't know. I was kind of hoping to be in a position where I would have so I don't
know. Okay.
That's not really something to talk about on the channel.
All right. That's fair.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's just, something worked out on.
Yeah. Oh, I do find the thing beautiful. It's scenery.
Yeah. Sorry, I just didn't think our viewers would care much about our personal plan.
And that's okay.
In terms of that part. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. With the convention, since it's new, I don't know the schedule. I kept looking to see if they
Gotcha.
They haven't yet, I assume.
I'm sure. I think they kind of have to.
So it's hard for me to know if Warren's going on.
Gotcha.
I mean, that's the only unfortunate thing with a lot of conventions. I feel like the panel schedule comes out.
Yeah. There we go.
Especially in terms of deciding, because like with this convention is close enough to us where it's like
that it is. Sorry about that, ladies and gents.
The
screen
cord,
decided to screw around with us.
The HDMI cord decided it's not going to display the image on the TV, so
yeah. Temporary. Go back.
So that fall to his head, which is as you can see.
Right. Thanks, Bob. I appreciate that. Then I'm the one another.
But yeah, like I understand that they give people time to submit their panel ideas and get approval and all that, but I still wish have the financial disposal to be like, oh, whatever, I'll go to a, we'll just do the hotel all 3 days for the room.
That would be nice, yeah. And I would appreciate that too. So we know what to look out for.
Yeah. I wish I was, I can afford to go to the convention, but outside of that, like, it's very strapping to pay for the
hotel. Yeah, it is. As we discovered last year.
Yeah. Especially in my current situation.
Oops. Well, that's about what I did. There. You just got a slight bouncing. It's Ecco, platform.
They're both great.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, if anybody that, like, programs the Nintendo Switch on Mario games is watching, please put Tides of Time on your Sega Genesis catalog. Please.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely. Get all.
Yeah. Because... I'm surprised it hasn't happened yet, because of the people who have played both, it seems like out of the American fans that have played both, it seems like a lot of them prefer the Tides of Time to the first one, so I'm frankly surprised.
Yeah, I've noticed that too.
I mean, I know it's kind of a thing where I'm sure there is a lot of don't know the franchise well, who only heard of the first game.
Oh yeah.
But a lot of that is like the fault of the journalists. No offense, video game journalists, but they talk about the first game and not the second one a whole lot.
Yeah.
Like on their list, like Sega Genesis games that could remake both.
Yeah, there's no rule that says
you
can't.
You could do a trilogy type thing and make make a 2.5D version of the future and release the 3S pack.
Yeah.
Ecco the Dolphin trilogy. Do it. Do it as an experiment. See if there are, you know, enough invested people. And then if there are, call up Ed Annunziata and make that darn third game.
Yes.
That he was going to make.
Yes, yes, guys.
Or just release a remaster of the first two and experiment that way, and then call him. You know, whatever you decide to do, whether you want to include this game or not, do it. Because I can guarantee you there is probably enough of a fan base to warrant reviving this franchise. Come on, we've been into reviving franchises in video games.
Let's go. Brash. Also work for Spyro. Games that we've also featured on this channel.
And those are both franchises that released games that did not hold up to the hype of the original trilogy. And I feel like with Ecco the Dolphin, this game did not hold up to the game. So this counts in that category, you know?
Yep.
It's Ecco's time. It should have been Ecco's time 2 years ago during his anniversary, but, you know, better late than never.
Yeah, that's what I would have done. Yes.
I mean, if you start production now, you might be in time for his next anniversary. No.
That's true. The anniversary of...
It would be the 30th.
Right.
I mean, if you want to go with those miles. If you finish before the 35th anniversary, that's fine. But... I'm trying to think realistically, you know, if this game hasn't been made yet, which it hasn't as far as I know.
Yeah.
Unless it has been made and he's just waiting for the call from Sega. Sega goes, hey, can we make a third Ecco game? And he'd be like, aha, I'm two steps ahead of you. That could be, you know.
Exactly.
like he was saying, well, I'm just waiting for the call. Maybe he has something already. Maybe he has a prototype.
I would think he would. Yeah.
Considering the original Sega Saturn.
Yeah.
He might have a prototype that he just needs to dust off and update.
Oh, yeah. That's an easy thing to do.
I mean, why not? And even if you make it with the older graphics, I mean, Sonic Mania was a big hit doing just that.
So yeah, they did that.
And Sonic Mania does.
Oh, wow.
I think it did. Unless I was losing it. I think it got a sequel. Day being my birthday, you know, my birthday, so I'm still kind of trying to get my spirits back up. So if I say some crazy crap, just be patient with me, because, probably still not one thing for this is
that's okay.
That's probably why, as you guys noticed, I was singing probably a good portion of the first half of the story. I am not super good. Swallowing emotions, pretending to have a completely opposite emotion. Something I'm trying to work on, which is sad. I wouldn't really think that's a good thing to work on. Oh, gee, you should work on hiding your emotions, but unfortunately it's kind of necessary in some situations.
That's true.
As toxic as it is to me.
I understand that, buddy.
Supposedly, the idea idea for his third game would have involved Ecco going to the past and So basically saving the to go into hiding.
That would have been good.
Yeah.
I think so too.
It would have been I think Ecco would have viewed it in a way that him redeeming himself because basically he felt partially responsible for the vortex coming back and attacking him. Because attacking the asteroid, because she followed him. I think him going back to where it all started to put an end to the vortex at that point, I think he would have helped me. I'm not saying he has to redeem himself, but he probably feels that way, and I think that it makes sense looking at it from that standpoint. This game, since it's kind of a game of sorts, people are kind of, well, how does this work with the other two games? And I think that's where a lot of the confusion is. But, you know, in terms of the fans that care about the world, it was really confusing. Myself and
the seems
that. Yeah. Until I read that it definitely was a game, I was confused as well. This game's past, but basically the Guardian. The Guardian looks nothing like this. That's why I initially just thought, oh, this is a completely different company, and they have the rights to Ecco, but besides that, they have to do their own thing. That was what I thought, until I did more research and realized, well, Appaloosa is Nobel Prize, just...
Yeah.
Minus a few people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Who's dead?
Forget me. I can't
remember. Ed and Lisa.
He's one of them, yes. Somebody must have. That must be.
I don't know, I don't have the exact list.
True. Regardless, the team that made Med work in the first few games wasn't fully there.
Right.
I worry there was a feeling that was just pay tribute to the first two games and do it in 3D.
This is speculation, but we're still a lot of the same programmers, and I would really have to do a lot more research, which is a little bit difficult. But there are communities I can reach out to if I can't find the information on the usual sources.
Yes!
Because even though, website I used to, the fan site I used to frequent is not running anymore. They still have a Discord community, so I'm just kind of a socially awkward person, so I haven't joined their Discord. Hey, do you know who was not involved because based on their website, the Caverns of Hope,
great name, by the way.
It is. I can tell that they were more in the positive camp when it came to less unfortunate thing on the end, but I felt like, at least at the time it came out, a lot of the American fans around me were with like this small sliver who knew the first two Ecco games. And hey, initially I was one of them. I tried to give this game.
And I feel you did a great job. You are giving this game a fair chance. It's a long series. We have seen so much of this game. Seen, and we've made it this far.
Yes,
I feel like I'm getting closer.
Yeah.
There's this tiny oomph that stops me from like I'm finally getting better at that triple platform.
Yeah.
After a lot of tries. Sorry about that.
Noticed more background noise in our videos lately. It's because and while eventually we may figure out a way to block out the heat, we haven't yet. And it's also because, you know, this is our basement, and
yes, we literally are in our basement.
Yeah. It is behind walls and a closed door, but that doesn't block out everything, so, and, you know, since I share space with my mom, I kind of have to get her okay before I do. It's just kind of where I am.
It's okay.
Eventually I won't. I don't know what point I really be at that point, but I'm hoping it's soon.
No. I'm sad when that happened.
Yeah, you know, especially like always when I get a cold and have to do something with my voice. It's like, no, stop it. If this is my life. Don't mess with my voice. So I have to figure out if there are any ways to make that happen less. If you guys happen to know, I don't know if that's possible. Just, well, you know, cold or gonna do something. I'm not that much I don't have that level of experience where I know how to keep doing voiceover with the call. So until I get to that point where I can safely do it, and doing the channel too, like I do a lot of it where I use my voice.
Yes. No, I don't think our viewers would. Yeah. They'd be concerned.
It should be like, why did you replace Kevin with a robot?
I wouldn't, and,
no.
Yeah.
No, that would go against me.
Correct, especially when it comes to, Albert and the Iceman.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, we are.
Alright, guys, hopefully we'll have more luck next time.
I think we will. Yeah, that's the checkpoint.
Okay, so anyway, guys, we will see you in the next part.
Take care, everybody.
Bye.